Can you hear me now? It's going to have some reverb on it, but can you hear me? Sorry, it's been so long since I've done this. I've almost forgotten how. I don't know if you can hear me. Otherwise, you can just play your cello, which is totally fine. Okay, great. So we'll just have a little bit of reverb on my voice. I had plugged into a different input just so that I could avoid the reverb in the way that I was doing this, but here we are. Alrighty. It's good to be back. It's nice to see all of you here. And I'm very excited to be playing for you after so long. What happened is I got hired to work a full-time job as a video producer for a big company. And so I'm still working on the album. I've got about 4 tracks done. It's slowed down a bit since I started working. But the album is still happening, and I'm still working on it. Let's see if I can get this window full frame for myself. Yeah, sorry, it's been so long since I've done this. Okay, here we go. Let me know how y'all have been doing in this crazy world that we still live in, and how you're feeling. Let me know where you're listening from, what you're drinking this morning for your morning libation. I've got some coffee here. Again, apologies for the reverb in my voice. Okay, I'll talk to you all very soon. I'm going to go to the next slide.
Thank you.
It's really nice to be back here again. Again, apologies, I've got a little bit of reverb on my voice, had a little bit of technical difficulties, so I had to plug into the input with reverb on it, my cello input. It's great to be back here. I'm sorry that I've been gone for so long. Life happens. So I'm looking down because that's where I can see all your comments. I'll look at you. It's just so nice to be connected again with this community. We're back 2 years after Morning Cello started, 2 years after the pandemic happened, and all the other things that are happening in the world. It's been a strange shift in the world today, and it's always good to build and stay inside of communities and to share and interact with other communities to make sure that we've got friends and family around. And that's what the original intention of Morning Cello was. Actually, the original intention was to keep playing the cello during the pandemic, but then it turned into something that I had no idea it would turn into, which is this amazing community. Which, if you're not already a part of it, there's a Morning Cello Family Facebook group, and y'all are still talking to each other and posting, even though I haven't played in a couple of months now. And that's just really warms my heart to hear that you're all still communicating. If you haven't joined that group yet, I recommend it. There's a lot of great people in there. Just kind of pulls the community from these live streams into, when the live streams aren't happening. So that's a great way to stay connected with other people in the Morning Cello family. And music is a beautiful thing. I've been a little disconnected from it lately. I've been working on the album quite a bit, which is a slow process because I'm still learning all that on my own. A little bit of help from my buddy Todd Boston. So I've laid down four of the probably 8 or 9 tracks. The reason I slowed down is that I actually got hired in a roundabout way I wasn't looking for. Like, I got hired full time to be a video producer for the company Autodesk, producing video for construction software, which is actually kind of right in my wheelhouse. I love being on construction sites. Many of you know that I like to build. I have to post a picture. I just built the most beautiful table I ever built. But I also was hesitant to post it because it's like, hey, where's my album? You're working on woodworking stuff? You're not recording? But it's funny. Woodworking is one of the things where I don't get bored or distracted. It's just like 10-hour state of like standing, even a chisel and hammer and a saw. It's almost like really physical sort of moving exercises. It's almost easier to even turn the cello. It's just like going out and doing woodworking. Before I got this new job, I was actually like trying. I'm like, maybe I should put together a woodworking business. Maybe I should put together this business. But it's kind of cool being working full time again. My first full time job in 6 years. But that doesn't mean that I won't be recording and not playing. think is actually sometimes it can be easier to approach your art when you don't have the stress of trying to make your living with them. And so once I get the album out, I'll plan to still try to release and publish one track every couple months. And so that's kind of where I'm looking at that moving forward. I'm going to go ahead and play some more for you. Thank you again for being here. It's just, you know, it's amazing to have you. And I look forward to connecting with you all again more often in the future. I think I'm thinking about doing these every 2 weeks or every month. It's actually my boss who, after I got hired, was like, oh my God, I just found a YouTube channel and you got to keep doing this. I'm like, oh, it's going to work. Like, it's going to work hours, but sure, cool. And so I got to kind of learn about go ahead and keep doing this, which is exciting. So. I plan to hope to see more. All right, talk soon.
Thank you.
haven't, it's funny, I haven't even, like, picked this thing up in a couple of months, so it's like, sometimes you play better when you get away from the instrument longer. And I didn't have to tune it. She was just still in tune. And so many of you know that I got this new cello right at sort of the new year, right at the end of last year. And I took my old cello and I put it up for sale in Chicago, and it just sold. Which I'm really excited about because I'm just kind of interested. I wish I could do a documentary on the next life of my old cello, like the relationship it has with its new owner. It was bought by a student. I think it was a high school student who was about to go to conservatory, and so I hope that it serves him well. And that's really, really exciting to know that my old cello is off on a new journey with a whole other person who's probably a better cello player than me. So I'm sure the cello will be happy. Alrighty, I want to play a little bit more for you. Thank you again for being here. Being here, just showing up, but also being here for each other. Morning Cello is a community, and when there's difficult times in our lives and in the world, it's important to stay connected to people, especially with the pandemic, keeping people so far away from each other and so disconnected. But surprisingly, it was a whole new era of human communication. Being able to communicate and have meaningful relationships through the lenses of our computers and phones and using technology. Although it is nice to be back with people, to be back in restaurants, to be out. I saw music once, I think, once during the pandemic. Oh, my family and I, my folks visited, and we took them to a comedy club in Portland, which is like our new favorite thing to do, is to go to this comedy club called Helium. They have actually some pretty big names that come through there. We saw Michael Yo, who's the headliner. I think he's got a Netflix special. And he was really funny. It was just nice to go and just laugh with an anxiety. And so I recommend getting out there if you feel comfortable to go re-experience the world. But the best part about that whole trip was my son, Yo-Yo, getting to play his grandparents. He just loved them. Mimi and Big Papa. Back home in Indiana, the other grandchildren call them Mimi and Papa, but Yo-Yo calls me Papa. And so he calls Papa, my dad, Big Papa. And then by the end of the trip, he was calling me Small Papa. And my dad would be like, "Can I poke you in the bed?" He's like, "No, I want Small Papa." And many of you have been on the journey of me raising my son. He's doing just amazing. He, and sort of the last time you saw me, I was like a zombie. I wasn't sleeping, but Yo-Yo's now sleeping. He's nearly potty trained, and he is hilarious. Just the funniest, sweetest kid that loves to share, says please and thank you. It's like, I couldn't be luckier, and I love him so much. Anyways, I'm going to go ahead and finish out this set for you. Thank you for listening to me babble, and I'll talk to you soon. Thank you. some. A little bit of rock and roll in the morning to get you started. Might be the morning where you are, might be the afternoon, or it could be the evening if you're overseas. But it's, either way, it's great to be here. For me, I'm just waking up. It's almost half past. Let's see, I'll take my phone here. Apparently, your phone doesn't recognize your toe. We got 8 minutes. 8 minutes because I got to get back to work. I got to tear down the studio and get ready for a meeting at 10 because I have meetings, which is cool. I'm going to keep playing since there's only a little bit left. I won't bother you with all my babble. It's just nice to be here and just know that I will be doing these more often. Also, I have a full-time job. I will be closing down my Patreon. It just doesn't seem right since I'm doing my own. And so I want to thank all of you for all the support during the pandemic. That support actually really helped me out surviving as an artist and a musician during the pandemic. But I just didn't feel right taking it. So moving forward, I will be closing down my Patreon. And that's that. All right. Talk to you soon. Thank you. Okay, there we are. Now I can hear my voice. It's not a bunch of reverb on it. I want to thank you all again for being here. It's just so nice to have you. And I look forward to seeing you next time. I'll put something on the calendar soon. I'll be traveling a lot for work. I'll be going shooting on set. And so I just got to kind of plan around that. And but please stay tuned. I hope to post, I've been meaning to do it forever, just post a video of one of the tracks I've been working on from the album. You'll recognize it as one of your favorite melodies. And, you know, feel free to reach out. I'm still here if you ever have any questions or comments. If you just want to say hi, feel free to shoot me a message on Facebook or through my website, and I'll get back to you. Thank you again. My name is Joshua McClain. This is Morning Cello. I broadcast live from Portland, Oregon, and I'll see you next time. Until then,